Hey, we're back. We're going to talk a little bit about vascular equipment and instruments. So this is a peripheral vascular instrument demonstration. We're going to go over some basic instruments in that aspect. So let's go ahead and just jump right into that, okay? Here we can say a basic stuff on our table. This is for vascular. Now, peripheral vascular, what is that for? The peripheral, right? Veins, arteries, percutaneous cut downs. So instruments that's involved in that aspect. Suture boots, right? These are a countable item. These are for vascular. They go on maybe mosquitoes in the aspect of protecting sutures, right? We look at these double arm sutures prolene here, the 6-0 prolenes. So these mosquitoes will get these suture boots on here. We get these suture boots on here and they will protect the thread. That's what they're designed for. These are a countable item used in peripheral vascular kind of scenarios. Next up here are the blocks or boats. These are for the clip appliers in vascular cases. These are a repurposed clip applier. We have blocks, meaning the different sizes, blue and white, maybe a medium or a small. And they correspond to the color on the bottom of these repurposed clip appliers. These come disposable. They are a hemostatic device to stop bleeding and microbleeds, small little vessels, boats, right? Now remember, these are countable items, suture boots, blocks or boats. So when you do your count, these need to be counted for, okay? Moving on to sutures. Most common type of suture used in vascular, the prolene, right? 6-0 prolene, right? 7-0 prolenes. Now, can't see on that one, but when you do your counts, you gotta realize they're double armed, meaning there's two of them in here, right? So when you anastomose something, bringing something together, or you're putting a patch together, they're designed to make, start on one side, make your way to the middle, then suture to the middle. So it's double armed on both sides. Prolene, typically most common type of suture used in a vascular type of case. Here we have some hemostatic agents, snow, and we have, this is a Surgisil. We have snow. Looking at the snow or the Surgisil, the difference of those, here's the Surgisil. This is Surgisil. And this is snow. These are all absorbable hemostatic agents, or that oxide cellulose. The biggest differences of these are from the snow and Surgisil is just exactly. It's a little bit more fine on the snow and it can get in a little bit more crevices. They both have the ability to stop bleeding. That's what they're designed for. Hemostatic agents are really important. Obviously, any kind of vascular case, bleeding is the issue, right? So we want to make sure that we have something to stop that bleeding. Vessel loops, different sizes, different colors. You have a yellow one, you got a blue one. They come in many different colors and sizes. What are vessel loops used for? And I'll show you down yonder here. Here's a good example of, my crude example, of a carotid. So carotid endarterectomy, right? We have to isolate the carotid. We have internal, external, common carotid. That's the anatomy involved there. And as you can see, the vessel loop is wrapped around there. It's a retracting device. It retracts back the carotid. It also stops blood flow, stops it, or it can let it go. So it controls that blood. And it can do that on the other side too, in any kind of small vessel. So vessel loops retracts blood flow during that case. This can be any kind of cut down. So when they say cut down, they're going to do make an incision to isolate the artery, isolate what they're working on, opposed to where it's like a percutaneous type of situation. Now, another way you can control blood or control any kind of scenario is something with a Rummel hook. Now, the Rummel hook is right there. It's exactly what it is. It's a hook. And it has on here, if you look, these little rubber, you cut those into multiple pieces. That's called a Robertson catheter, or a straight cath. Originally, it was a full catheter, And as you can see, we cut it up into smaller little pieces and we put it over the Rummel hook. And I have an example. Now we have a Rummel hook or Rummel tourniquet. And as you know what a tourniquet is, it's there to stop bleeding, right? We want to control bleeding in some fashions. We wrap around something called an umbilical tape. We wrap it around that vessel. We hook that umbilical tape and we push these rubber catheter parts onto the actual umbilical tape. And we push down onto the actual vessel. We clamp it off and now you can control blood and not so traumatic on these vessels, right? So many ways you can control blood. Tourniquet, a Rummel tourniquet, a Rummel hook, or vessel loops, right? Or umbilical tape, right? These are all countable items, right? The vessel loops, umbilical tape, even these rubber catheter pieces, as many, if you cut up four or five pieces, guess what? It's five or four pieces, right? You count as many pieces as you have, right? We'll come back to that in a minute. Let's go over some instruments briefly here, right? Going over this one, this is the Mills Dennis forceps. Typically used if you're stripping off kind of plaque or arthrosclerotic material off the intima of the vessels. It's a ring forceps, it's very fine. This is a Mills Dennis micro forceps. I use it a lot of the time in carotid surgery. You're stripping off plaque off of the actual intima. It's very fine in that aspect. But the Dennis or the Mills forceps. Now, a common theme in a lot of these instruments for vascular, clamping and occluding, right? We want to stop bleeding in some aspect. Most common thing I get is, why are they angled in different directions? Why are some bigger? Just like the anatomy, some anatomy is smaller, some vessels are smaller, and some people have different, or it's harder to access certain vessels in some aspects. So there's a clamp for that purpose. I just gave you a selection of the most common kind of clamps. There's a lot of other ones. For this video purposes, we're gonna go over some common ones. The Cooley's clamp. You can see that name there, Cooley's. Now, it comes out of a little bit of an angle. They come a little bit large. They're a non-traumatic, almost like a Debakey kind of serration on there. Again, if you come over here on these vessels and you have to come to a certain angle, and we need to clamp off something, right? Come at an angle, clamp off. You can see how they're designed to come at an angle, maybe not be in the way of the operative site itself. Now, I'm not gonna spend too much time just maybe on what the name is and what they look like. The Cooley's clamp. Most common type of clamp you're gonna use, maybe right behind the profundent. And a lot of these bigger clamps here, we're gonna go over. This is what they call the K aorta clamp. You can see here this aorta clamp is really big. Why are we using bigger clamps over smaller clamps? Well, we know the largest artery in the body, the largest artery in the body is going to be aorta, right? Or the largest vein is the vena cava. Now you can just imagine if we had to come underneath and clamp something off, that would be a perfect tool for that. So that K aorta clamp is designed for that. Now, the Satinsky Vena Cava clamp, it's in the name, right? They come small, they come large. Again, you can see over here, sometimes they're designed to come at an angle. Maybe you have to come around something. But a lot of these clamps are designed, the Vena Cava clamp, to clamp off the Vena Cava. So if you had to come underneath, if you're working on maybe some kind of procedure that you need to isolate that Vena Cava, or even medium-sized vessels, this is the job for it. The Satinsky Vena Cava clamp. It comes kind of a medium size, but also can come a little bit larger. Now, as you get a little bit bigger in these clamp sizes, you have the Beck aortic clamp. So this is the Beck aortic clamp. We have the Vena Cava, a K aortic clamp. Again, it's really hard to distinguish. What in the heck is the difference here? I wouldn't spend too much time trying to figure that out. It really is designed. Everyone has a unique type of a clamp. Doctors have preferences. Again, you need the tool for the job that they're trying to get to, and everyone's anatomy is a little different. This is a little bit bigger. This is very similar to the Vena Cava, but this aortic clamp, obviously these for larger arteries, especially the aorta, Vena Cava, a little bit typically the larger of the arteries and veins. Forceps, this is the Castroviejo, right? It's a lock-in mechanism, and I have a proline on here. You can barely see it. I'm gonna drop it. Drop it. Yeah, it dropped. You can see it has a lock-in mechanism on here. You don't have to squeeze this really tight. And sometimes these things malfunction, so make sure they clamp, right? It's for very fine, small sutures, 7-0, 8-0. They come a little bit smaller. You can use these in eye cases, neuro cases. But for vascular sense, these Castroviejos are typically for these smaller type of sutures. They're more fine, microsurgery, right? They're very delicate, Castroviejo. Looking over here, we have a pot scissors. You can see how they angle. They have a different angle here. Some come 50, 60 degrees. Now, if you can just picture here, this is the carotid. We do an anteriotomy right at that bifurcation here. We do that with an 11 blade. How are we gonna extend that incision? You can see this pot scissor is designed to come at a certain angle and extend that incision, right? They come in many different little shapes and sizes, but it's really about the degree they can come backbiting. And maybe you can see different examples of these here. Can't see very well, but they do come in different degrees based on how they have to get to a certain anatomy. But the pot scissor is designed to extend arteriotomies or incisions in arteries, to extend incisions, right? They're designed that way. They're designed for that object or that in mind. Now, some forceps. This is the vascular type or a Debakey type of forcep. Find this in general trays. But typically in vascular, we use this because it's for delicate types of tissues. The Debakey. We have the Potts-Smith tissue forcep. You can see that little kind of mechanism in the middle. You can't mistake that because it does have that little kind of clamp and it'll stop it from causing too much trauma on there. It locks a little bit too, if you hear it click. So it's very fine, a little bit more finer than the actual Debakey. A common forcep used in vascular. Another forcep, obviously this is a very similar one, it's not what I wanted, but it's called the Gerald forcep. We don't have that one, so. Now, we have our selections of Bulldogs. We have the Glover Bulldog. We have the Diethrich Bulldog. We also have the Debakey type of Bulldog. These are really smaller than you anticipate, right? If I never showed this to you, you have no idea what they are. I said a bulldog clamp. Maybe you're thinking these are large clamps. Now these are countable. Obviously your hospital policy would dictate if we count them or not. Most hospitals will. They're very small. Anything that's small, it can get lost. Look at this bad boy. Very small, right? They're to clamp off small vessels, capillaries, small little vessels in that aspect. Either you're clamping off temporarily. Sometimes they can use them in carotids. They'll come here and clamp off. It really is a doctor's preference of how they want to use these. You can use this with a Satinsky clamp, profundent clamp, vessel loops, controlling blood flow. It's a lot to that, right? These are bulldog clamps. These are countable items. This bad boy here, if someone's in a true emergency said we nicked the aorta, grab this one. This is the Debakey aorta clamp. Large, right? Right down in the belly, right down in the belly. You can see how large this aortic clamp, Debakey aortic clamp, goes right down in that belly, right? Clamps off the aortic. So it's designed to get through, there's something called the Maddox maneuver where you're moving your colon and you're getting access to the aorta in an emergency six to clamp it off. Why are we clamping off? We don't want to bleed out, right? Stop the bleed. Get in there and figure out what we need to do to fix that. Now, just to kind of cover up here, is some other items typically used in vascular. This is a Javid shunt, right? Why do we shunt? People get confused over a stent or a shunt, right? Shunts are typically a bypass around to continue the blood flow. Fempop, we use a bypass, the saphenous vein, to go around the defective area to continue that blood flow. In this case, we want blood to continually flow as we proceed to take the plaque out of the bifurcation in this carotid. So a Javid shunt. And here's another tool that we can use for that. It's called a Javid shunt clamp. As the suture gets all stuck up on me. This is the Javid clamp, right? It's designed, come around, you put the shunt in and it holds that shunt in place. That's a very crude example, but the Javid shunt is designed to hold that shunt in place, right? The Javid shunt. Now we have a couple other selections of these Javid shunts here. Why do we have multiple sizes? Again, you don't know what the size of that anatomy you're looking on. So maybe you want to have a selection of these sizes of shunts. I usually show the doctor, he'll pick out the size he wants. Now, over here are some bifurcation or some grafts. We have a bifurcation graft. The most common types of grafts used are bifurcation, which just mean a Y, right? This probably typically is the beginning of the, or the end of the descending aorta and into the actual iliac, into the femoral arteries, or we have straight grafts. Typically used in a lot of the cases if we're doing aortic aneurysms, any kind of typically aortic aneurysm where we're doing an open technique, these grafts can be used in that aspect. Bifurcation means Y, and a straight graft used in a lot of these. Now that might fall into a little bit more complex, not peripheral vascular, maybe in a little bit more open hearts or more extensive type of surgeries, but you can use this, and especially if you go open in types of grafts. Okay. All right, we're gonna finish up there. This is just a little example of some peripheral vascular instruments, most common type of stuff used, suture boots, prolenes, boats, or blocks, some grafts, some hemostatic agents, vessel loops. Just a quick little example. There's so much stuff I want to go over. Hey, how about you leave your any questions? Hit that like button. Share this video. This is all going to help with the algorithm. Get this video out there in some aspect. All right, thank you for watching this video. This was just an educational example of peripheral vascular stuff. If you can like this video, subscribe to this video, subscribe to my channel, comment. Obviously, you're gonna see a lot of things in here maybe you have questions about. This is your time to ask some questions for that. Again, I thank you, and I'll see you next time. Bye.